Well, thanks for joining us, Courtney.
Pleasure to be here. Thanks for having me.
So in the lecture, we've been talking a bit about stereotype threat and how people from stigmatized groups can sometimes actually end up behaving in ways that apparently confirm the negative stereotypes about them. This seems pretty concerning. Like, why do you think that happens?
So there's a lot of research that's amassed over the past 20 years on stereotype threat, and there's been a lot of different mediating mechanisms or causes that have been explored. And I think a lot of the reasons that seem, if we want to sum it up, it's co-opting these working memory resources. So you really want to disprove the stereotype. You know that you're a strong math student despite the fact that you're female. You've always taken advanced placement classes. And so you're really motivated to do well on this test. But when you worry that someone's going to evaluate you on the basis of this girls aren't good at math stereotype, you don't necessarily have the same amount of working memory, the same cognitive resources to focus on the task at hand because you're distracted by the stereotype. You might have some negative thoughts about the stereotype. You might even be anxious about not performing well. And so the bottom line is that part of the reason that these performance decrements come about is because people don't have the cognitive resources to focus on the task.
So it's not at all that they take on the content of the stereotype and believe it or anything like that?
No, not at all. So these effects are most likely to emerge amongst people who are really good at the task. So it's not, I'm not particularly good at math, I never claim to be. And so if somebody says, here's this math test, look, we know that you're female, so you may not perform that well, but please try as hard as you can so we have an accurate sense of your ability. I'm gonna be like, yeah, I know I'm not good at math, who cares? So that won't be particularly threatening for me because I don't identify with math, but it's most likely amongst women who really do identify with math and therefore don't believe the stereotype because they're really good at it. The original research that was done was at Stanford with women who were majoring in math.
So they're highly motivated to disprove the stereotype.
Oh, absolutely. In our own research, we even found that people who showed these performance decrements were more motivated to disprove the stereotype.
Okay, so maybe if you could tell us a bit more about your research. So you've done one of the interesting studies of yours that I remember is with putting people in a driving simulator. So if you could tell us a little bit about how you did that study and what you concluded from it.
Right. So look, it's probably no surprise to learn that women are stereotyped to be poor drivers. And it's interesting because really the sort of people who are the poorest drivers in terms of who has to have higher insurance premiums and things like that are male, young men, basically. But despite that, there is this prevalent stereotype that women aren't as good behind the wheel. And so we use that to our advantage to bring women into the lab and either remind them of the stereotype or not. And then they were in a driving simulator and it had all these different PowerPoint visuals, and it feels quite real when you're doing it, even though the car is not moving at all. But you're sitting in an actual car with regular steering wheel and gas pedal and brake pedal and so on and so forth. And we found that although the women in the stereotype threat condition drove in a more cautious kind of way, they were more likely to stay in the line, they were less likely to go over the speed limit, when something unexpected happened, and in this case it was a group of pedestrians jaywalking, they were more likely to run over the pedestrians. Of course, it was all simulated. Only cartoon characters were hurt in this study. They were more than twice as likely to run over the pedestrians in the stereotype threat condition.
So what did you do to remind them of the stereotype?
Well, so we had two different studies, the study was we had somebody dressed up in a suit and we played this little video where we said that it was the road traffic authority trying to understand why occupational drivers are mostly men and why women are more likely to be implicated in accidents. Now it is the case that occupational drivers are mostly men, but women are not more likely to be implicated in accidents. So we did have a bit of deception happening there, but we wanted to ensure that we really had highlighted the stereotype of women as poor drivers.
And so it's for those women, they're the ones who are thinking, you know, that's not right. You know, that's not, you know, how I feel about women as drivers.
Right.
So they're trying really hard in the simulator, but then they've also got that information, you know, active in their mind as well. You know, that extra motivation.
Yeah.
So they're trying to do two things at once.
Right, exactly. And look, they were able to drive more cautiously and they were able to be safer drivers on those kinds of dimensions, but it was when something unexpected happened that they didn't have the necessary resources to respond very quickly. And we followed that up in another study, and we in fact showed that this stereotype threat manipulation was basically like a cognitive load manipulation, that it really did just take away from those resources to, you know, from the task at hand.
And basically what we know from the cognitive load research is it really doesn't matter what the task is. If you give somebody another task that's, you know, cognitively taxing, they're going to do worse.
Right.
Yeah, so it's not you know, perhaps surprising. Right. When you give people two things, they're worse at it than one.
Right. I mean, sometimes when it's something that's automatic, cognitive load doesn't impact our performance. And that's probably why driving for, and we did select women who'd been driving for a certain amount of time so that driving was more automatized, because we know that it is. We've all had that experience where you get home at the end of the day and you're like, did I stop at the red lights? How did I get into my driveway? And so driving can be automatic, but when something unexpected happens, that's when it goes from the automatic to more carefully controlled behavior.
When it needs that extra cognitive effort.
Yeah, and that's where we found these performance decrements.
And so is there anything we can do to alleviate the effects of stereotype threat? Like maybe, you know, maybe if you belong to a group where there are sort of strong negative stereotypes about performance in a domain, and you're motivated to disprove them, you know, you're suddenly behind the eight ball. What can you do to alleviate the effects that they might have on your performance?
So there's a few things that have been shown in the literature. So one is simply letting people know, hey, you might be feeling a bit anxious or a bit uncertain, and that's normal. There's this thing called stereotype threat. And it's, you know, it's been shown to impact behavior, but don't worry about it. You know, basically normalizing it at the end of the day, letting them know that those feelings that they're having are typical and that they should just put it out of their mind and work on the task at hand. Another thing that's been used effectively is self-affirmation. So just using yourself as a resource and reminding yourself, hey, you know, even if I don't do that well on this test, at the end of the day, I'm a good person and I've got my family or I've got basketball or whatever it is the person really values. But by using the self as a resource, they can overcome stereotype threat. I'd say another one that's been shown more recently is to get people to reappraise the stereotype as a challenge. So we know that when we experience stress in our life, we can appraise it as either a threat or as a challenge. And if we get people to reappraise the event as a challenge, something they can overcome, the performance decrements are less likely to occur.
Excellent. Thanks very much, Courtney.